अस्सलामु अलैकुम। योर लैब नंबर 7 इज़ शो द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ अ मल्टीप्लेक्सर एंड डीमल्टीप्लेक्सर एंड रिप्रोड्यूस द एडेड सब्ट्रैक्टर यूजिंग मल्टीप्लेक्सर। लेट्स फर्स्ट डिस्कस द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस लैब। देर आर 3 ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस लैब: टू एक्सप्लेन द बेसिक फंक्शनैलिटी एंड वर्किंग ऑफ अ मल्टीप्लेक्सर यूजिंग लॉजिक गेट्स, टू एक्सप्लेन द फंक्शनैलिटी एंड वर्किंग ऑफ डीमल्टीप्लेक्सर यूजिंग लॉजिक गेट्स, and to display the results of various application of multiplexer using hardware and software platforms. In this lab, you are only going to perform using the software. What is a multiplexer? Multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit that transfers large number of information over a smaller number of channels. Multiplexers select binary information from many input lines and direct to a single output line. A multiplexer of 2^n inputs has n select lines which are used to select data to be sent to the output. If you see here, this is a 2×1 multiplexer. It has 2 input lines which are said to be data lines and 1 control line. So if control line is selected 0, D0 will be sent to the output, and if control line is selected as 1, data D1 will be sent to the output. This is a 4×1 multiplexer. It has 4 input lines which are said to be data lines and 2 control lines. So if you select 00, D0 will be sent to the output. If you select 01, D1 will be sent to the output. And if the selection pins are 10, D2 will be sent to the output, and if they are 11, D3 will be sent to the output. Demultiplexer is opposite to that of a multiplexer. Demultiplexer is a combinational logic circuit that transfers a small number of information over a large number of channels under the control of selection signals. The general demultiplexer circuit has n controls or select signals and 2^n output signals. If you see here, this is a 2×1 demultiplexer. It has 1 input line and 2 output lines. Where this is a 4×1 multiplexer, again this has 1 input data pin and 4 output lines. Now let's see the lab tasks. Your lab task number 1 is implement a 4×1 multiplexer using NAND gates. This is the equation of a 4×1 multiplexer that you have already studied in class. You have also studied this circuit in the class. As it is a 4×1 multiplexer, so there are 2 selection inputs and 4 input lines. Here the enable pin is used to turn on the circuit. When the enable pin is high, the data will be transferred to the output. When the enable pin is low, so no data will be transferred to the output. Here the enable pin is working on an inverted logic. So when the enable pin will be 1, no data will be transferred to the output no matter what your selection pins are. When the enable pin will be 0, only then the data will be transferred to the output. If you see here, when you select 00 at the selection inputs, only data I0 will be transferred to the output no matter what I1, I2 and I3 will be. Only I0 will be transferred. Similarly, you see here, when the selection input will be 01, I1 will be transferred to the output. When the selection inputs will be 10, I2 will be transferred to the output, and when the selection input will be 11, I3 will be transferred to the output. Your lab task number 2 is to implement a 4×1 multiplexer using 74153 IC. This is a dual multiplexer IC. Let's first discuss the pin configuration of this IC. Here EA is the enable pin of first multiplexer, S1 and S0 is the selection pins of both multiplexer, as it has 2 multiplexers. Here I3A, I2A, I1A and I0A is the input pin of the first multiplexer, and Y is the output pin of first multiplexer. Similarly, here EB is the enable pin of the second multiplexer, I3B, i2 भी, i1 भी, i0 भी एंड y भी इज द इनपुट एंड आउटपुट पिन ऑफ द सेकेंड मल्टीप्लेक्सर. यू हैव टू अप्लाई 0 एट द इनेबल पिन सो डैट द इनपुट डेटा मे बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू द आउटपुट. इफ़ यू सेलेक्ट इनेबल पिन 1 means you, if you apply high voltage at the enable pin, no data will be transferred to the output, no matter what you have selected at the control pins. So apply 0 at the both enable pins so that the data can be transferred to the output. Your lab task number 3 is to implement a 4 cross 1 demultiplexer using basic gates. So as it is a 4 cross 1 demultiplexer, so it has one input and four output lines and two selection inputs. So the data will be transferred when the enable pin is 0, as it is working on an inverted logic. So when the enable pin is 0 and data pin is high and the selection inputs are 0 0, you will get y0 at the output. When the selection inputs are 0 1, you will get y1. Similarly at 10 selection pin, you will get y2, and 11 you will have y3 at the output. In lab task number 4, you have to implement a 4 cross 1 demultiplexer using 74139 IC. This is a pin configuration of the IC. You have to implement this circuit and verify your results. When the enable pin is high here, no data will be transferred. When the enable pin is 0, only then the data will be transferred to the output, as it is working on an inverted logic. Now let's implement some other circuits using multiplexer. In this part, we are going to implement half adder, full adder, half subtractor and full subtractor using multiplexer ICs. You can implement the half adder using 2 cross 1 multiplexer. In 2 cross 1 multiplexer, there is one data pin, one select pin and one output pin. This is the truth table of the half adder. A and B are the inputs. These are sum and carry are the outputs. So you can either use A as your data pin or either B as your data pin. In this example, we are using B as our data pin and A as our select pin. You can see here when the select input is 0, you are getting 0 and 1 at the output, which is equal to B. So we have directly joined B at the first pin of first multiplexer, which is I0A. Now when the select input is 1, you are getting 1 and 0 output, which is the invert of B. So we have used a NOT gate here and joined it with the second pin of the first multiplexer, which is I1A. The pin I2A and I3A are grounded as it is not required in the circuit. Now let's move to the carry output. So when the select input is 0, you are getting 0 at the output. So we have joined the first pin of the second multiplexer with the ground, as we are getting the 0. Now when the select input is 1, we are getting 0 and 1 at the output, which is exactly equal to B. So we have joined B with the second pin of the second multiplexer. The next two pins are grounded as it is not required in the circuit. The enable pin are also grounded as it is working on the inverted logic. We are getting the sum here and the output here. Implement this circuit and verify the results. In the next task, you have to implement a full adder using multiplexer. So this is the truth table of the full adder. Here we are going to use AB as our select pin and C as the data pin. This is the sum output and this is the carry output. So when the selection pin is 0 0, you are getting sum as 0 and 1, which is equal to C. So we have right here C. So when the selection input is 0 1, you are getting the complement of C at the output. So we have written here C bar. Again, when the selection inputs are 1 0, you are again getting the complement of C, which is we have written here C bar. When the select input is 1 1, you are getting the output as equal to C. C. So we have right here as C. Now let's move on to the carry output. So when the selection inputs are 0, 0, no matter what the data pin is, you are getting 0. So we have right here 0. When the selection input is 0 and 1, you are getting the output exactly equal to C. So we have right C here. And when the selection inputs are 1, 0, again you are getting the outputs equal to C. So we have again right here as C. When the selection inputs are high, we are getting 1 at the output. So we have right here as C. So this is the circuit that we have implemented using this table. Implement this circuit and verify the results. In the next lab task, you have to implement a half and full subtractor using multiplexer IC. Follow the same steps as used for the full adder and half adder to verify the results of half subtractor and full subtractor. For the post-lab task, you have to design a half adder and full adder using multiplexer. You have to use the basic gates only to implement the circuits. This is all for the lab. Thank you.